Jamie Duke says a former Falconer. You may know him as a talented broadcaster, but what you may not know is a lot of the great work that he has been a part of through his Put Up Your Dukes Foundation. And Jamie's here this morning to talk about the International Opioid and Concussion Conference taking place in Atlanta this week. There's so much happening in Atlanta this week. Welcome, man. It's been a long time.
Good
How
to
you
see
doing?
You. You look great.
You do too. Yeah, I think we were talking about you got your almost kind of got your broadcasting start here. You used to work with us in our Falcons fifth quarter specials.
Ken.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah, you never forget your start, right? It's always good to see you, Jamie. So we're talking about serious matters here amid all the hoopla and fun this week. And the news broke out this week about the former Falcon great, the Mr. Falcon, the first Falcon ever, Tommy Nobis. And now, of course, he passed away recently, but now we know that he did suffer from CTE. And if you read the article, It's heartbreaking to hear what his family had to say about what this man went through. This is so sad.
Yeah, and that's the thing about it. You know, this affects so many families, and it really goes down deep when you think about, you know, here you have a guy who, you know, one of the nicest men you ever know, and then you hear the comments from his daughter, you know, and family just, you know, because CTE or, you know, the effects of it are just so devastating, you know, not only to the players, but also to their loved ones.
So tell me about the conference this week. I know you guys are talking about specifically opioids on one day and concussions on the other. Let's start with concussions because we're just talking about Mr. Nobis here. What's the goal? What do you guys hope to accomplish this week?
Well, the goal is that there are solutions that are out there. You know, we developed a treatment, and Dr. Kevin Jackson, he is our neuro chief. He's a spine surgeon at Northwestern University. He's going to be conducting research on drip fusion, which is a treatment that we have in the area of concussive injury. You know, and we also have treatments that we're talking about because this opioid epidemic is a huge, huge problem in this country. And the thing is, the solution is actually here. And so it's more about letting people know that there's a solution here, and, you know, and that's what we're here to do.
Yeah, and opioids obviously ties in with football, with painkillers and injuries, but it ties into such a huge problem in this country as a whole.
Yeah, when you think about it, because, you know, for those that are sitting around driving in the car, take a sip of your coffee. Mm-hmm. And, you know, when you take a sip of your coffee, there is a 0% chance that you're going to be hooked on an opioid. If you broke your arm, car accident, or prior to a surgical procedure or post-surgical procedure, if our treatment is given in lieu of the opioid, then there is a 0.0% chance you're going to get hooked on an opioid. And so, therefore, the goal here is to let people know that there are solutions and there is a solution that is out there, that is available, that is covered by every major insurance carrier today. And so the opioid conference and what we're going to be doing is really kind of, we've got two big announcements to make. One is going to be in the area of prevention. So we're going to be partnering with, our research is going to be conducted with Regional Medical Center out of Orange, South Carolina, Dr. Charles Williams. He's not a doctor, but Charles Williams is the president and CEO. And so they recognize, because South Carolina has a significant problem in the opioid area. And so we know that if this treatment is given post-operatively, there would be a 0% chance that a patient would get hooked on an opioid. And then the other thing, as it's germane to the football league, is that very excited about, there's a league called the MFL, Minor Football League. It's led by a former Patriot player who's here. And so all the Pats are all excited about that. You know, Richard Miles, and he and Dr. Melvin Forbes, who's brought Johns Hopkins in, I mean, to do research. And so what we're going to be doing is we're going to be treating all of those players, and we're going to be looking at, number one, pain, acute and chronic. We're also going to be looking at, just as we started this conversation with about Tommy Nobis and myself and other players, we're going to also be looking at acute concussive injury and what we call refractory concussive injury, which is basically, CTE is a post-mortem designation.
Right.
And so basically we call CTE, TBI, refractory concussive injury. And so we're going to be investigating at the first league wide, and they've got 32 teams, 50 players on their team, and so we're going to do the research. So that, what that's going to do is that research will now be able to be presented to all, you know, whether it be high school association, soccer association, NFL, NBA, all these different associations, so they can see the data and they can see the research and see there is a solution that is here.
That is awesome. That's awesome. Well, thanks a lot for coming. It's always good to catch up with you, and people can come in attendances too.
Yeah, absolutely. Right? It's at the Druid Hills Country Club. Right.
We'll give them all Thursday the information on that. Yeah. We'll have a link to it so that everybody can find it. The Drip Talks are tomorrow, as Jamie mentioned, tomorrow and Friday at Druid Hills Country Club, just right down the road from here. And the events start at 9 o'clock each morning. Go to our website, fox5atlanta.com, for more information. We'll be right back. 8:54 is your time. Stay with us. You're watching Good Day Atlanta.